Remarkably, we have reached the final month of the regular season. February basketball begins tonight as IUPUI plays host to the top team in the Summit League, the Bison of North Dakota State. Alongside former IUPUI head basketball coach and director of athletics, Bob Lovell, Greg Rakestraw with you. Thank you so much for joining us for IUPUI basketball on ESPN3. And speaking of three, Bob, three consecutive losses now for IUPUI. Why has this team struggled so mightily when more was expected of it going into Summit
League? Well, number one, playing on the road is difficult. But I think what's happened is that it's a little bit of a confidence issue, Greg. I mean, it's an inability to get some stops at the end that you need, you know, make some free throws, get the big basket to the right guy. You put all that together, you're playing good teams. I think we realize that. So when you have an inability to score and stop some people at the end, they're in every ball game. But the problem is you have to finish, and I think that's been their biggest issue right now.
And if you look at this North Dakota State team, Bob, what they do is simply they're not going to beat themselves. They're solid defensively, and simply put, they do not turn the basketball over.
Well, nine times a game, I mean, think about it. They lead their league in turnovers. You know, in that stat is, you know, one of the best in the nation. You think about it. You don't give your opponents extra chances. They're also a tremendous team defensively. And I think the biggest thing about them, you mentioned threes. These guys are tremendous from the three-point line. And I think if I were IUPUI, I'd be concerned about this from this standpoint, Greg. They've won six games on the road. They're one of 21 teams in the nation who have six road wins to their credit right now. And they are a solid, solid basketball game, obviously leading the Summit League to this point.
They are led by Paul Miller. We saw him here a year ago as a sophomore. He was outstanding. Very solid junior season. And like a lot of these Bison players, Bob, a lot of interchangeable pieces. He can play a couple, three different spots.
Well, he can play wherever he wants, quite frankly, with his ability to knock down threes. I mean, think about this. In his last six games, 24-41 from three. You absolutely need to find where he is at all times. And he scores a lot. He lets the game come to him. That's the thing about it. Doesn't force kickouts from the post, ball reversal, transition. Any way he can get some space, he's going to be knocking down threes.
One thing IUPUI has not had to do this year very often is make a change in the starting lineup. They do because of an injury tonight. Evan Hall is out dealing with a concussion. So Aaron Brennan gets his first start of the year, and Bobby's playing his best basketball. He's had double-digit scoring games in each of the last three.
Well, you look at those stats and you think, why would you feature this guy? Well, a lot's going to be expected of Aaron Brennan tonight without Evan Hall, and he's going to get a lot more minutes. And you're right, he's been playing very, very well in the last three games. We know he can play. He has that ability to post and score inside. He can put it on the floor. He can step out and knock down three. He's a great defender. I'd be concerned about foul problems because the depth on the bench at the post is kind of thin tonight.
Jaguars beat the Bison at the buzzer. Here a season ago, they're looking for a similar result. If less drama is involved, that would be great as well. IUPUI, North Dakota State, starting lineups, opening tip-off. Come your way next here on ESPN3.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at driveubler.com because Ubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Ubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Ubler help you now. Click driveubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Ubler has it all.
People always tell you what not to do. Don't hold your breath. Don't play with fire. Don't talk to strangers. Don't spend it all in one place. Find out what you can do. IUPUI, fulfilling the promise.
The season, Darrell Combs being introduced by the public address voice for IUPUI basketball, Scott Behringer. Aaron Brennan into the starting lineup for the first time this year. It's the second leading scorer, though, we can focus on now, Bob. Matt O'Leary's had a very good year, but he's had three straight games of 9 points or less. Getting him on track offensively has to be a key for Jason Gardner tonight.
Well, it really is. When you think about the absence of Evan Hall, obviously, you know, he not only has to pick up his scoring, I think more importantly, he's got to be more of a force on the glass. Now, you know, he's capable of double-doubles, has a number this year, but you're right. And, you know, we're concerned about him not scoring in double figures. He's been at nine in those games. But, again, it does address, I think, some of the things that are – that are troubling the Jags to this point, and that's a lack of some consistent effort, especially at the end of basketball games. But, you know, the performance of Brennan, the performance of Matt O'Leary up front, Josh James is going to have some quality minutes. It's not a big North Dakota State team. It's a team that, you know, they'll space you. They can shoot it. They can put it on the floor. They don't turn it over. They create matchup problems. And if they have an open look, they have guys. Think about this as a team, how well they shoot the basketball from three. So it's a certainly a challenge. This is the other part of it, Greg. This starts the second half. You want to make a statement, you know, going through league play. You know, you're a little disappointed in how you played back at home after a couple tough road losses. Make a statement in how you play in this ball game and get yourself going for the second half of league play.
A pair of third-year head coaches in tonight's contest. Jason Gardner in the center of that huddle and on your screen. Of course, former Indiana Mr. Basketball that played for Lute Olson at the University of Arizona. His counterpart tonight is David Richmond over on the bench for North Dakota State. And his predecessors at NDSU have gone on to do very good things. Saul Phillips led North Dakota State to a tournament win back in 2014. He's now at Ohio. Before that, it was Tim Miles, who now is the head coach at the University of Nebraska. And North Dakota State won the tip so well, they tipped it to their own bench out of bounds to IUPUI.
Yeah, you talk about Tim Miles and Saul Phillips. Those are two good basketball men. And it obviously underscores the success that they've had at North Dakota State.
Tim Miles kind of got the transition from Division II to Division I rolling, then left for Colorado State right as North Dakota State joined the Summit League. Saul Phillips did a great job, took him to a couple of NCAA tournaments. Now it's David Richmond. And to start this game, it's the young man we featured getting his first start of the season, and Aaron Brennan.
You call it. You got to have Aaron Brennan step up and make plays, and he certainly did on that first one. And what's good is he was able to score off the dribble. North Dakota State, very good at taking away your dribble.
When these two teams played back on January the 5th, defense was optional. 93-89, North Dakota State won that night. North Dakota State on the season turns it over 12 times a game. You get to conference play, that number shrinks to 9. Miller turns it over on their first possession.
Well, but IUPUI turned them over 9 times in the first half in that first ball game, Greg.
And one thing of note, just the way these two teams match up, you will see a lot of interchangeable pieces going both directions. Here's a steal by Miller. Thomas racing back, and a good basket for Paul Miller.
Pack line defense, Greg, right out of the textbook. You know, they switch all screens. You know, they really pack it in. You're going to shoot over a contested hand, and they will not double the post. They're really good at how they play this defense.
Allen Thomas, the graduate transfer from Kent State. This is O'Leary, who draws the hand check foul from A.J. Jacobson. One thing that's also unique about this North Dakota State team over the years, they have pulled from various different states, most notably Minnesota. Mm-hmm. Two of their leading three scorers this year are kids from North Dakota. Jacobson, one of those. The other, maybe the sixth man of the year in the league, in Dexter Warner.
Well, you always talk about, you know, like IUPUI, obviously, own your town, own your state, and they certainly have done a much better job of it.
Up under McCall, not that time.
One of the issues here, Greg, is that the way North Dakota State plays, you'll notice they're not giving help. Not much help on the dribble, not much help on the post. They'll take away your three-point opportunities on passes out of the post.
This is Cabelas, young man from California. Got a good look, couldn't get it to go. Really played a good role for this Bison team as a freshman. Deep trailer three for O'Leary, and that's a good sign for the senior from Terre Haute.
I think he heard you mention that he had been under double figures in the last three outings.
And that was of note because he had been in double figures for 19 straight games before those 3 days worth of struggle. Combs trying to match him. Not that time, but O'Leary, the offensive rebound. That's one thing that IUPUI did exceedingly well against the Bison on January the 5th. They picked up 22 offensive rebounds in that game.
Well, you got to be there, you know, obviously in transition, in secondary transition for long rebound opportunities.
Brennan. That's virtually a patented spot for Aaron Brennan.
Well, we know he loves the short corner. Great dribble penetration and kick out. again, if they're going to switch screens, not going to give that much help in the post, you got to be conscious of kickout opportunities.
It is a North Dakota State team that enters two games clear in the loss column for the top spot in the Summit League. Good block out by O'Leary. Brennan pulls down the rebound. North Dakota State has played one fewer league game that has IUPUI. They are coming off a bye, are the Byes, and they last played on Wednesday night, a victory against Oral Roberts. Combs again. This time the result is better, and IUPUI off to a stellar start.
Well, again, ball movement has been much sharper here than the last time we saw them play at home. You know, great opportunities, quick ball movement.
Jacobson goes right at O'Leary and scores.
Well, it's just a nice clear-out move when Jacobson able to go one-on-one inside.
Jags have been a great shooting team at home this year, and they have made on average over 10 threes a game at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum. That number is three in the first 4 minutes as Combs with six.
They might be on base, but this is a North Dakota State team that only allows 37% from three. So this is an uncharacteristic start for them defensively.
Opponents shooting 41% against the Bison this year as Miller scores.
Man. We think of him as a three-point shooter, but you know what makes him difficult, Greg, is that right there shows you an ability to put it on the floor and go.
And on a per-game basis, the Bison allows 68 points a game. But as mentioned earlier, IUPUI put up 89 in a loss earlier this season. That ball was touched last by North Dakota State. Out of bounds to IUPUI, which will bring us to the media timeout. Well, a team that's lost three in a row needs a bit of a boost to start. But O'Leary provides just that. Jaguars lead 13-6 on ESPN3.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Great Dating City Barbecue.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Three-point shooting can be the great elixir for teams that are struggling. Jaguars 3 of 4 from three-point range to start this game.
Well, they've been good looks. I mean, we talked earlier about shooting over a contested over a hand. And really, to this point, North Dakota State has not contested those jump shots. Quick ball movement, good people movement, so to speak, have led to clean looks and 3 out of 4. We know the Jags shoot it well in this building.
Dexter Warner in the game for North Dakota State. Senior out of Bismarck, North Dakota, their second leading scorer, their leading rebounder. Plays starters minutes but comes off the bench as a sixth man. For IUPUI, Josh James has checked in, the senior from Andrean High School. Thomas on the drive, and ball got tipped right back to him by James.
Yeah.
The shot clock should not have reset, right. And that's the reason for the immediate whistle.
Keep an eye, though, Greg, on the switches. You have some mismatch situations, but the pack line kind of saves you in terms of how you have your people in terms of packed in this defense. But there are plenty of opportunities for post mismatches if you can take advantage of it.
O'Leary again.
How about it at the horn? Well, clearly, I mean, he understands his importance to this team, especially now without Evan Hall. They've got to come up with somebody. You know, he's got to continue to score in the opportunities he has.
Combs and O'Leary, the two double-digit per-game scores with this IUPUI team. Pair of older seniors, they have brought their A game tonight. Combs with a block. It went right back to Dupree. James got a piece, and eventually O'Leary out of there with the board. And Thomas with the nifty move to scoop and score.
Gets him with the crossover. You know, you now have Ron Patterson in the lineup. You've gone a little quicker. Josh James giving you some great minutes inside.
Now Miller doesn't get the roll. This is as good as we have seen IUPUI play in a while. Patterson for three. Not that time.
Yeah, but you know the thing about it, Greg, rather than go against that five-on-five defense, look at the opportunities in their primary break and their secondary break to this point.
Well, you can state that we have the battle for the sixth man of the year in this league taking place tonight between Warner for North Dakota State and Patterson for IUPUI. Thomas got caught with the reach in, and Warner will get two free throws.
Well, you can see no help. You know, both teams haven't given that extra body on the post player. And Dexter Warner, you know, three bounces to the rim and powers it up. And you go back to this. Again, rather than go five-on-five, I like one-on-one with my opportunities with Kellen Thomas in the break.
Warner, a 74% free throw shooter. Both of these teams, 68% from the line on the season.
Surprising, because both teams shoot the ball reasonably well.
Couple of new faces for North Dakota State, at least entering the season. Pair of freshmen, Tyson Ward and Dengu check in. As Warner makes them both. Ward, a 6'6 freshman from Tampa. Gu, a 6'8 redshirt freshman from Sioux Falls, South Dakota. For IUPUI, TJ Henderson in there for the first time, the sophomore from Cecina. The Jaguars play without Evan Hall tonight, missing his first game of the year due to a concussion. Brennan, not that time. Already two early baskets for the junior from Garin Catholic. It's a North Dakota State team that doesn't get too deep into their bench. Both teams likely playing an eight-man rotation tonight. Shot clock at five. Good job by Brennan.
It's a good defensive possession. After a shaky offensive possession, good defensive possession, and make Warner shoot an off-balance shot.
Combs and O'Leary currently out of the game. Points might be at a premium, but good hustle by James. One pass too many by Brennan.
I think you're right. You know, great idea. You're okay with that. But, you know, Aaron, I think a little hesitant missing that last shot.
Miller with the left hand. Tipping is good by Warner.
You know, the ability to have that sixth man like Warner, like Ron Patterson, guys that can score and do a lot of different things.
Yep. And steps called on Brennan. And that'll bring us to the media timeout. But IUPUI has built an early 8-point lead. Four made three so far. Lead the way for the Jaguars.
It's pretty simple. That's the car she wants, and this is the price she has budgeted. The question is, can we make that happen? I'm gonna get a coffee.
Your husband is a tough negotiator.
No, that's not my husband. He's my Indiana Members Credit Union manager.
I better get my manager.
We are passionately committed to our members. We'll help you get into your new vehicle with 1.9% APR financing for auto, home, business, and more. Call or visit Indiana Members Credit Union today.
Go, a little dribble drive.
Feel the intensity.
of NCAA March Madness.
The shot drops.
You've got to see it to believe it. The 2017 NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Championship first and second rounds. March 17th and 19th at the Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Visit ncaa.com/MBB tickets for your seats today.
Jaguars leading North Dakota State by 8. These two teams played 3 times a year ago, splitting their matchups on each other's home floor. And then met in Sioux Falls in the opening round of the Summit League tournament in the 4-5 game. IUPUI the higher seed, but the Bison the better team on that day in March. North Dakota State would make it the championship game, would lose in the final. Their season would end right there at 20-13.
Yeah, I mean, a solid year. You can tell it's a veteran group. The guys back from that team who played for a championship act like it. I mean, they just have the feel of a veteran basketball team.
Top 5 scorers all return from last season for the Bison. Last 4 have been scored by North Dakota State. Matt O'Leary returned at the last timeout for IUPUI. Tough shot by Miller. Ward keeps the possession going, but Cabela's cannot cash in, and that'll be an over-the-back foul whistled against the Bison.
First 3-point attempt of the game, Greg. 11-17 on the clock for a team that averages about 15 3-point attempts per ball game and has been deadly from that particular range.
A couple of empty possessions last time down for IUPUI. Hence the reason why O'Leary was brought back in the game. Everybody outside the arc right now for IUPUI, and Brennan has little problem with that. We have talked throughout the season, Bob, how he has developed that part of his game.
Well, and what makes it dangerous is, you know, your post guys. You know, Brennan and Matt O'Leary have the ability to step off the post and knock down three. They're legitimate three-point shooters. Great defensive effort on the double up.
The double by Henderson. The dish by Henderson. The finish by McCall.
Again, transition so important when you play a team that plays half-court defense as well as North Dakota State does.
And Henderson will get whistled for the hand check and going for consecutive steals on as many possessions.
We talked about this before too, Greg, is that you're trying to get your defense to provide some offense. And this is a perfect example. You get a great double team on the post that leads to a run out and a great pass and a tremendous finish. You know, just instead of working so hard and putting so much pressure on your half-court offense, get some things off your defense.
Combs returns. Patterson back to the bench for IUPUI. Ward for 3 and buries that one.
Dialed it up. Great penetration and pass by Paul Miller. Jags have done a nice job in defending Miller to this point.
Ward averages 6 points a game for North Dakota State. And Brennan couldn't hang on. That's the 4th turnover against IUPUI, 3rd that Brennan's been a part of, and he will check out as Josh James returns.
Good minutes from Josh James. Good minutes from Aaron Brennan. We knew he was going to get more minutes now without the presence of Evan Hall, so stepped up and did well.
Yeah, James kind of the 9th man in the normal 9-man rotation tonight, player number 8. And that might sound like that big of a difference. Trust me, it is.
It is. Yeah, instead of getting 7 to 10 minutes now, you're looking at, you know, 12 to 15 to 16 minutes.
Miller getting a breather for North Dakota State. James got him on the arm. 2 free throws coming for Dexter Warner.
Yeah, but Tyson Ward on a spectacular post feed. I'm not sure how that ball got there. You talk about delivering a pass inside. That's a great pass for the rookie.
Warner has the only 2 free throws of the game to this point. Right at about his average on the year, 2 for 3. Warner and Dupree, the only seniors in the regular rotation for David Richmond's squad. And as talked about, a team that brings back a lot of experience from a season ago. Their lone league loss for the Bison at Denver back in mid-January. And Combs going to be called for the offensive foul.
Yeah, just got when he tried to split him, he knocked the ball away, and then trying to get the ball, knocks over the defender. it's a tough possession. Good defense on the part of North Dakota State.
It's now five turnovers for IUPUI, Bob, and that has been an issue this year.
Doesn't have control. Great job of selling the foul, too. It has been an issue. There's no question. And it's been especially difficult late in the ball game.
Warner on the drive and finishes.
He is a tough matchup now. He really is.
He's got seven off the bench to lead the Bison. O'Leary again.
Holy moly.
Making up for lost time. His third three of the opening 11 minutes.
Well, you know, it's the screen and step back. You know, you screen, you little step back, you slip it. And that one was a step or two further. And it was nothing but when it left his hands.
That is six threes to start this game for IUPUI. But again, that is to some degree the norm here in this building. Cabelas and McCall just took one step too many and walked into them.
You like the patience of North Dakota State. They get the little weave. You know, dribble penetration is hard to guard, as we all know. And with certainly when you have a guy like Carlin Dupree, you can turn the corner and go to the rim.
Cabelas, young man from Escondido, California. This has been a North Dakota State team that has recruited from all over the Midwest. They've had young men from North Dakota, South Dakota, Minnesota, Wisconsin. Cabelas, though, from California, and Ward from Florida that have made their way to Fargo.
I like that, though. I mean, guys want to play for successful teams. They want to play for winners.
Well, it's also a school that has absolutely tremendous facilities. No doubt about that.
Yeah, you get on campus, it's hard not to like it.
Right. You make the NCAA tournament three times in a seven-year span, that will catch people's attention. 2009, 2014, and 2015 trips to the NCAA tournament. And as mentioned, a victory against Oklahoma 3 years ago for the Bison. O'Leary again, not that time. And Miller just checked back in, grabbed the board. Both Dylan Miller and Paul Miller back into the game now for the Bison. Single digits now, the shot clock. Jacobson, tough shot.
Tough shot, but you know what? He didn't hesitate. Good spacing, spin move, no one there to stop it.
Brennan and Patterson return. Next dead ball for IUPUI. Catch and shoot O'Leary. James with the hustle, but eventually off his hands, out of bounds, and it'll be North Dakota State basketball. The threes have been flying early and often for IUPUI. They led by seven here at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
People always tell you what not to do. Don't get your clothes dirty. Don't bite off more than you can chew. Don't cross the line. Don't make faces. Find out what you can do. IUPUI, fulfilling the promise.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Well, three-point shooting has been part of the arsenal all season long for IUPUI. They have made six so far in tonight's contest. The six threes and four twos do the quick math for IUPUI. And it's a Jaguar team, Bob, that's aiming to break some marks that haven't been set a few years ago, given how well they have shot the three-pointer this year.
Look, 37th nationally. You're shooting 38%, almost 39% from the field from three. It's a pretty remarkable stat.
Jaguars on pace to have three players make more than 50 threes this year, which is something that they have not accomplished in program history.
No, and it's, the other, we mentioned it, it's your perimeter guys, it's your post guys who are all capable of knocking down three.
Little step through hook by O'Leary.
Good move. The move he wants just did not stay down.
Seventh shot for O'Leary here in the game's first 13 minutes, and little zone for IUPUI. They tried this last time down.
Well, yeah, it's a good change because North Dakota State's crept back. They're down seven. Got to be aware. It's a risk, though, because you've got to know where Paul Miller is. It's a decent, it's a good three-point shooting team.
Combs flies at him, but Miller gets the roll.
Look, you have to take the risk. You take the chance. Miller, as you know, is very capable from three.
Last time it was this close, it was 10-6 in the early stages of the half. O'Leary again. Right-handed hook didn't work. I'll go to the left instead.
Speaks to his versatility. I also think that you look, he's been very aggressive offensively, Greg. His mindset is I'm going to take opportunities. I'm not going to sit back. I'm going to go right at people, and he's done it all night.
Already the 20th double-digit performance of the season for O'Leary. But his first since the Jaguars beat South Dakota State here 2 weeks ago. No for Miller. Jacobson tried to tip out the rebound and went right to Aaron Brennan. Patterson, the trailer three. And the bus has arrived at Indiana Farmers Coliseum.
Well, you know what? 53% from three in the last. And he's had six straight double-digit games. And he is lighting it up when he's in this building.
And he gets a hand on a passing lane there. So between the defensive work and the three-pointer by Patterson, that is what he leads this team in. Their leader in three-pointers made with 52, and he leads them in steals as well.
He just gives you the spark, and he's accepted the role of coming off the bench and doing what you do. And, again, it bumps it up to 11. It's just a great run.
7-0 run by IUPUI that just ended for Tyson Ward. And Ward had a little message for some of the students.
Yeah, he did.
Sitting on the baseline.
Yeah, he did. You know what? He's a good-looking freshman. You look how he's passed the ball. Not afraid to take that shot.
O'Leary might have intercepted one intended for Ron Patterson, but
I think he did.
If you can get the three the old-fashioned way, that's fine. Yep. O'Leary's got 13. Yeah,
and Durrell is saying, I was throwing that to Ron. Again, Matt O'Leary is a smart guy, as we've addressed, at a 4.0 this past semester. So he knows in the last three games he hasn't scored as well as he needs to. They need him to be the threat that he is. You like his ability to knock down the three. What's been impressive the last three trips down, he's been inside going to the rim.
That is the first free throw of the game for IUPUI. And he missed from O'Leary, who is a 73% free throw shooter. Shot clock at 9. Outstanding ball movement by the Bison, and Cabela's cashes in.
Special ball movement. That is just classic textbook sharing the basketball. Look what it got him.
This lead has kind of hovered around this point for most of the half for IUPUI. Been in double digits a few times. Bison just had it down to 4. All in all, still a very impressive start to this game against the top team in the Summit League standings. Shot clock. Brennan in time. Did get the rim, but couldn't get the rebound.
Yeah, just really kind of got too quick and forced late in the shot clock.
Ward got in the lane. The freshman has been impressive. And for North Dakota State, Bob, that is now 15 bench points of their 30 between Werner and Ward. That'll also take us to the media timeout. It's been a game of spurts. IUPUI on the run here. has brought the lead to 11. Right now it's 5.
Pizza Hut makes the best pizza under the moon. You see, when you're raised by wolves, there's no 10-any deal where you can carry out a large Pizza Hut pizza, any toppings, any recipe, any day of the week. No, you just starve while your wolf brothers sandbag all the fresh meat. But now, I can even carry out a large pan meat lovers for just 10 bucks, while Barky and Sparky look for their dinner in the woods like a bunch of animals. Look who's laughing now, wolves. The 10-any deal, because no one out-pizzas the Hut.
Great Dade City Barbecue.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Each of these two teams have been outstanding in terms of bench contributions this year. With Evan Hall out, Brennan's points move to the starting lineup. The battle of the bench being won by the Bison. They lead that stat so far, Bob, 15-3.
Yeah, and one of the main reasons, obviously, Tyson Ward and Dexter Warner. You expect it out of Warner. I mean, he's averaging 11 points a ball game and, you know, 7 rebounds. But Tyson Ward has been, seriously, I mean, he hasn't missed a shot, Greg, 3 of 3. He's been 2 of 2 from 3 and has played well defensively and has given them a tremendous lift off the bench.
Speaking of the bench, T.J. Henderson in there for IUPUI. McCall forces the issue, and Jacobson up to the challenge.
It's a hard defense to try to penetrate just by yourself on one pass. And that's a hard thing to do. You have to try to break it down, move it side to side, and attack it on the second or the third side or from the top.
Shot clock at 9. Now at 3. And that's going to be a push in the back on Warner. Watching Warner and O'Leary battles worth the price of admission, isn't
absolutely.
It?
Absolutely. You came out of a timeout. You got a good you turn it over, but you came down and did a nice job defensively. But that battle inside, again, North Dakota State is kind of, you know, you body up. They're a more physical team inside than what you realize. They're going to extend you out. They're not going to let you get to a spot on the post.
Patterson, the only man that has points off the bench so far for IUPUI. As Bob mentioned, double digits now in 6 consecutive games. And the left hand for the Broad Ripple native.
Well, we know he can score. He's the scorer. We know that. But that was one where he took advantage of a mismatch and a clear side and open post and went to the rim.
Ward leads the Bison with 8. Looking for the assist here. Doesn't get it. Henderson turns the corner and finishes.
He does that so well. When he's able to turn that corner, as you point out, he's tough. He can play through the contact, which he did there.
We reference bench points for IUPUI. Back-to-back buckets by players off the bench out of the timeout. Almost steps against Carlin Dupree. Now Ward.
Look out.
Again.
Oh. You literally in a no dribble, only have an option to go ahead and shoot it.
Now you could not have guarded the ball dribble handoff any better if you're IUPUI.
No, not at all. This is an example of when you're confident and things are going your way, just keep shooting them. A little confusion on the high ball screen with O'Leary and Darrell Combs.
Nice give and go. Good defense by Miller. Oh! McCall couldn't get the follow.
Two good looks, two point blank looks that did not go.
McCall gets whistled for the foul. And Paul Miller to the free throw line.
DJ McCall has done a nice job defending Paul Miller. I'd be concerned in the second half because Paul Miller has not really done much to this point. You know, strong move there. And DJ is big enough, quick enough to give him problems, which he's done.
And while North Dakota State has left a couple of points at the line, they're 4 of 6. They've been getting there on a little more of a regular basis. IUPUI just 0 of 1 from the free throw line so far.
Well, certainly it'll be addressed at the half. You know, granted, you're up 5 right now, probably soon to be 4. But you can't rely just on jump shots and going to the rim. You got to get to the rim more. And that's one of the things that North Dakota State has done well. They haven't fouled.
IUPUI has led virtually the entire way. They scored the first basket of this game, and they have not trailed. 13-second difference, shot clock and game clock. We'll see the Jaguars finish this one strong. O'Leary will help with that cause. He's got 16.
Strong enough. That's a half now. That is a tremendous half.
North Dakota State will take their use it or lose it 30-second timeout. 42-35, IUPUI in front. Now you're just trying to close it on a defensive stop if you're the Jaguars.
Well, you really are. And you don't want to come in and give up the three. You don't want to foul a shooter for the conventional three. You know, I'm sure that at halftime, Coach Richmond's going to say, look, when O'Leary goes out to 25, you got to guard him. I mean, it's not just at the arc. You know, Coach, do you want us to guard him? Well, he keeps knocking him down. I think we might want to get a hand in his face. If he goes to midcourt, get a hand in his face. And he has been very assertive and confident from the start of the ball game. Well, I think with 10, I think you're looking at Paul Miller, or you're looking at Werner inside. So you look, they're going to run some action for Miller, or go to Werner right there and look for a skip if you can get him. Oh, they've got him on a jump ball.
And the arrow points to North Dakota State. With 3.5 seconds now left to go in the half.
Well, it's a good strategy. I mean, Werner, you know, can power it up to the rim. And he also has Miller spotted up in that opposite corner for a skip pass.
Got a veteran officiating crew tonight, Lamont Simpson, Chris Beaver, Glenn Mayborg. Quick conversation after Combs and Werner got tied up. Werner, no, and the putback would not have counted had it even gone in. Well, the Jaguars led by as many as 13. They led for most of the first half. An outstanding start for IUPUI, trying to knock off the top team in the Summit League. At the break, Jaguars lead by 7 as you're watching IUPUI basketball on ESPN3.
It's pretty simple. That's the car she wants, and this is the price she has budgeted. The question is, can we make that happen? I'm going to get a coffee.
Your husband is a tough negotiator.
No, that's not my husband. He's my Indiana Members Credit Union manager.
I better get my manager.
We are passionately committed to our members. We'll help you get into your new vehicle with 1.9% APR financing for auto, home, business, and more. Call or visit Indiana Members Credit Union today.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at driveHubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click driveHubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Pizza Hut makes the best pizza under the moon. You see, when you're raised by wolves, there's no 10-any deal where you can carry out a large Pizza Hut pizza, any toppings, any recipe, any day of the week. No, you just starve while your wolf brothers sandbag all the fresh meat. But now, I can even carry out a large pan meat lovers for just $10, while Barky and Sparky look for their dinner in the woods like a bunch of animals. Look who's laughing now, wolves. The 10-any deal, because no one out-pizzas the Hut.
Courtside here at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum alongside Bob Lovell. Greg Rakestraw with you. 42-35 the score for IUPUI. And I'm not sure if you would classify this in must-win territory, Bob, especially given the fact that you're playing the top team in the league. But this would make life a whole lot better in terms of breathing room for IUPUI. And North Dakota State keeps that top spot in the league. It's a nice tiebreaker to have in your back pocket that you've got to win over the best team in the league.
I could argue that they're all must-wins. As a former coach, man, you want to win them all. But you know what, Greg? I mean, their confidence has been shaken in these last three games.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a team that needs to feel better about itself. They've been close. We've talked about it. They've been in games, haven't made some things at the end. This is the kind of half you need. But the other part of it is you have 20 more minutes to play, and you don't want this to be, oh, no, here we go again type territory, which has been part of the problem for them. But to this point, it's been a good half. They played well defensively, taking Paul Miller out, not allowing him to get started, and have shot the ball extremely well, especially from three.
And this is a North Dakota State team that does have four double-digit come-from-behind wins.
Absolutely.
On the season. There is a track record there. So there you go, a look around the Summit League standings. And again, if you're a glass-half-full type of person, Jaguars only a couple of games back of getting to third or fourth in the league. But avoiding that number nine spot in this league is massive. Remember, the team that finishes in ninth, does it make it to Sioux Falls, South Dakota? Their season will end as of February the 25th. And up until last night, the Jags were in a three-way tie for that last spot. There was a game in the league last night. Denver beat Oral Roberts. So the Jaguars come into tonight's game at least a half game clear of ORU.
Yeah, but I think if you're Jason Gardner, your conversation is we don't need to look at stats. We need to look at ourselves. We need to play better. We just need to take care of our business. If we take care of our business, these things, you know, guys like us like to look at it and fans like to look at it, but take care of what we have to take care of. Make plays at the end, defend better at the end, share the basketball, be tough enough to fight through some things and finish up at the end of ball games, then the statistics will take care of themselves. The standings will take care of themselves.
Of note, IUPUI does have wins against the other two teams with three wins in league play against South Dakota State and against Oral Roberts as well. Again, this is one of three games taking place in league activity this evening. Elsewhere, Western Illinois is at South Dakota State and South Dakota is at Omaha. Of note, IUPUI is off on Saturday. So, again, things will kind of jumble up again in the league standings over the course of the weekend. But for IUPUI, they do not play again until a game next Wednesday night when they make a visit to Omaha. We'll take this quick timeout. We'll come back with more of our halftime show as you're watching IUPUI basketball on ESPN3.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Great Dating City Barbecue.
Back at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum, Jaguars leading by 7 at the halftime break. And time now for our special halftime guest. Although this guy is by no means a stranger at IUPUI basketball games, it's great to get him on camera. It is Andy Klein, who's now the dean of the law school at IUPUI. Andy, as always, it's good to see you, my friend.
Great to see you as well, Greg.
Tonight is Dean Night at the IUPUI game because you actually stepped away from being honored at center court to come join us here courtside. Tell us about what's going on here this evening.
So it's great. We have all of our deans on campus here. We have a lot of our IUPUI students supporting their schools. We've really built a great community around athletics here at IUPUI.
I was going to say, kind of to that point, what role does Division I intercollegiate athletics play on a campus like IUPUI?
It plays a tremendous role. It helps build community on campus and throughout Indianapolis. There's a lot of evidence that intercollegiate athletics and the engagement that it creates helps student success, and it also helps get the name of IUPUI out and helps the visibility of the university.
And going above and beyond that, again, you have always had a great passion for IUPUI athletics. We have not had to twist your arm to come to games, whether here at the Coliseum or in the days at the Jungle at the IUPUI Gymnasium. Why have athletics on this campus been such a passion of yours?
Well, I did spend 3 years before I was dean of the law school working in the chancellor's office. Chancellor assigned me the role of being his liaison to IUPUI athletics, and I had 3 years of tremendous fun working with a great group of people here. Greg, IUPUI is really a school that walks the walk when we talk about intercollegiate athletics, dedicated to student success as well as success on the court and on the field.
Well, and to that point, this was a basketball program that had a GPA over 3.0, which was basically copied, if not bettered, by virtually every sport that IUPUI offered in the fall semester.
We're very proud of that. Coach Gardner's done a great job. He's recruited a real high-quality group of young men, and they're great on the court as well. I think we're going to win tonight.
All right. What's new in the School of Law these days?
School of Law is doing great. We are, as you know, the school that trains, or maybe you don't know, we train a majority of the lawyers throughout the state of Indiana, train a majority of the judges on the bench in the state of Indiana, and things are going great at the law school right now.
All right, you're in the analyst chair. Break down the second half for me. What are the Jaguars going to do to hang on to this 7-point lead?
I think Jaguars are going to continue to play good defense, move the ball well on offense, and if we can keep hitting those 3-point shots, I think we're going to end up with a win tonight,
it's
Greg.
It's the cure for all ills. Buddy, as always,
great
thanks
to
for the
see
time.
You. I appreciate you having me. I really do. Thanks. George,
Andy Klein again, Dean of the School of Law here at IUPUI. Bob Lovell rejoins us next. We'll have first half highlights and stats. Jaguars lead by 7 here on ESPN3.
Oh, yes. There you go. A little dribble drive.
Feel the intensity of NCAA March Madness.
The shot drops.
You've got to see it to believe it. The 2017 NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Championship first and second rounds. March 17th and 19th at the Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Visit NCAA.com/MBB tickets for your seats today.
It's pretty simple. That's the car she wants, and this is the price she has budgeted. The question is, can we make that happen? I'm going to get a coffee.
Your husband is a tough negotiator.
No, that's not my husband. He's my Indiana Members Credit Union manager.
I better get my manager.
We are passionately committed to our members. We'll help you get into your new vehicle with 1.9% APR financing for auto, home, business, and more. Call or visit Indiana Members Credit Union today.
Good crowd on hand at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum tonight, and the home fans have been happy with what they have seen in half number one. Jaguars lead by 7. Let's relive some of those moments now with our first half highlights. And my guess is when you make 8 threes in the first half,
yep,
you're going to see some 3-point field goals for IUPUI.
Well, you are. You hope you don't see many of those replays in terms of turning it over. But Aaron Brennan off a little screen and a flare to the arc. Great defensive play. You talk about the threes, Greg, but also fast break points, 9-2 advantage for the Jags in the first half off some pretty good defense. But, again, the 3-point, the transition, here's a 3 off of transition. Great pass by Kellen Thomas to Ron Patterson, who's been on fire. But look, on the other side of it, Bison did not dack that D, even take a 3 until 11 minutes in. They go 5 of 10. I think the best player they had in the first half, Tyson Ward, really creating a matchup problems. But how about Matt O'Leary for the half? Man, oh, man, he has 16 points on 4 of 6 from the field, and you see it. You know, some really even stats in this thing. Both teams have taken pretty good care of the ball. I think the stat that you're happiest with is 12 assists because you've been sharing the basketball, which means you're moving yourselves and the ball much better than at times that we've seen in this building.
That is 12 assists on 17 field goals, by the way. And that turnover number for IUPUI was 5. It was about 5 about midway through half.
You're right.
A much better job of taking care of the basketball down the stretch.
It has been that type of game where both teams have played pretty solid defensively. It has not been a very physical contest. I think that changes a little bit in this second half. I think you're going to see especially, I think, with North Dakota State, I think you're going to see them take the ball inside as much as they can.
If you're Jason Gardner, what was your message to your guys at halftime?
Just keep playing where you're playing. You know, share in the basketball, take better care of it sometimes. We got to make sure that we find their three-point shooters. And the big key, I think, is you got to find Paul Miller because he is too good right now to be stuck. I know he has nine, but here's a guy who can change the complexion of the game from three in a hurry.
In terms of players with foul trouble, it's very limited going both ways. There are only 10 total fouls called in the half. A.J. Jacobson picked up two for North Dakota State, two fouls for D.J. McCall. If you're David Richmond at NDSU, what's your focus to start half number two?
Well, I think you really have to challenge your guys to get out and contest shooters at three. I think you have to also be mindful that this is a team, an IUPUI team, that likes to put the ball on the floor. So you got to do a better job on your on-ball defense. Secondly, when you switch, and you're switching most screens, you got to make sure that when you switch, you make that quickly, you step out, you try to make contact, and be near where these shooters are. I think you have to get much, much closer to your shooters. And offensively, we need to space the court a little bit better, get some opportunities inside with Warner when he's in there, and kick outs to our spotted threes. They can do that and do that very well.
Leading scorers in tonight's game, Matt O'Leary with 16 leads everybody. Darrell Combs, 8. Aaron Bennett, 7 for IUPUI. Tyson Ward with 11. 9 for Paul Miller and 7 for Dexter Warner for North Dakota State. Second half action comes your way next. IUPUI has the basketball when we return. They also lead by 7 here on ESPN3.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Lovely night here in central Indiana. First night of February. Thanks for spending it with us. Greg Rakestraw, Bob Lovell with you on ESPN3. Good student turnout here at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum tonight. We referenced the fact in the first half that North Dakota State has had 4 comeback victories where they have been down by double digits at some point in time in the game. That included the one 7 days ago against Oral Roberts. They were down 13 with 15 minutes to play and won by 10. This has traditionally been a very good second half team.
Well, you know what? They are a great second half team. If you think about it, you go back and you look at what they're able to do. I mean, we mentioned that they have they've won 6 games on the road. You know, they are 49% in the second half from the field. And they hold their opponents. I think this is the stat that really gets your attention. In the second halves this year, they've held opponents to 40% from the field. So if that holds, you get yourself a basketball game in the second half.
Starting 5 back on the floor for both teams. Thomas. Lost the handle on the opening possession.
Yeah, great steal. Great steal by A.J. Jacobson. A little down screen, a little flex action, and he steps right out and creates the steal.
Yeah, most of these teams will switch on all screens because the pieces are so similar going both directions.
That's a great point. I mean, you have post guys who can step out. Jags are a little bit bigger with Brennan and O'Leary, but these are two guys, as we know, can shoot it and can score inside.
O'Leary. Great crash by McCall, but knew he was going to the hardwood, had to get rid of the basketball.
Great hustle by DJ McCall, just not there.
Cabelas makes it a 4-point game.
Did we mention they shoot it well in the second half?
Both of his field goals tonight have been from 3-point range. O'Leary looking for number 5, and he's got it.
Well, again, he's had that kind of game. He's not been shy. He's looked for his shot. He's in rhythm right now.
Jaguars 9 of 13 from three-point range tonight. Nice dish by Dupree. That's an and one as Kellen Thomas gives the foul.
Yeah, but how you mentioned, Carlin Dupree breaks it down. Again, the weave, the dribble penetration, they broke down the defense. Dupree is able to penetrate deep. Great pass. You'll see it here. It's right. It's just a great pass. No rotation. You don't make that foul on a shooter.
My guess is that Dylan, as you see where his hometown is located, has some friends and family in attendance at tonight's game.
Yeah, he absolutely does.
That is just his 10th free throw of the season. He can exit, and he'll exit stage right as Warner returns.
I think, you know, Warner has it in his mind probably. I'm okay coming off the bench. You know, minute and a half in, he's back on it, and he'll get significant minutes.
Combs wide right on that one. Chance for NDSU to make this a one-possession game, which it rarely was in the first half. You see a lot of three-man weave, dribble handoff this North Dakota State team. Well, let's keep working until they get an open look. McCall gives the foul. That is his third.
How about Miller gets cut off on the baseline, has the great presence of mind to find someone on the perimeter, and an extra pass creates the foul.
Already a couple of quick subs in this half for head coach Jason Gardner and IUPUI.
Sitting here, you'd feel momentum in the part of the team in the green. You really do.
And they have been in this situation so many times this year. Already three road wins in league play. Only loss was on the road, coming at Denver. On the cut. Needs to go up. Miller finishes.
That's a great offensive possession. Didn't get rattled. I'm surprised Warner turned down the shot. But Miller has the presence of mind. Go to daylight. Great cut to the hoop and a great finish.
Combs got fouled before he found an opening. Just the fifth foul whistled against North Dakota State in tonight's game.
Yeah, but what you like is finishing at the rim, giving yourself an opportunity to get to the rim and finish. Don't look now, Greg, but it's a two-point ball game.
Cabela's picks up the foul. Full shot clock to work with for IUPUI. Now Brennan got that one.
It's a good move. You have Warner guarding Brennan. Flash to that high post, to that elbow, and you know he can make that jump shot all night.
Cabela's for two. He might ask for that one as an assist.
Yeah. Again, Warner is so hard, so active, he's hard to keep off the glass.
Also hard to, you know, blame a defensive player for not having the proper blockout angle on an air ball.
Yeah, that's hard. That's a tough pass to make. A really tough. Thought he had it. Tough to make. Chance to tie on the part of North Dakota State.
Third turnover of the half. Committed by IUPUI.
Yeah, think about it. You had five in the first half. Now you got three in the first 4 minutes of the second half.
Need to wipe a little perspiration off the floor.
Chris Beaver doing some extra work. Good young official. I had the chance to work with these three officials when I was, you know, in the Horizon League. They are outstanding officials. This, no wonder this game's going so smoothly. These guys are that good.
Dupree flying down the floor for North Dakota State. And that's a blocking foul against Aaron Brunnett.
Hard matchup, though. In the switch, now you got Brennan trying to go against Miller, who is active, is great off the dribble. And you see it, this is just a tough matchup, and it's a pretty good call.
Third foul of the half whistled against IUPUI. And the Bison have been to the free throw line eight times, IUPUI just one. That's also been just the nature of this game. IUPUI has been taking and making jump shots. Miller, the slip for Warner. Patterson just rips it away. Henderson, the fastball to Brennan. Ball got knocked away.
Warner clears some space. Man, oh man.
Cabellas got fouled by Henderson. O'Leary had him clean up top. Henderson got him on the arm. What IUPUI is upset about is no foul call.
Absolutely.
At the other end on Brennan's opportunity at the rim. Two free throws and we come back. Could tie this game up.
It's pretty simple. That's the car she wants, and this is the price she has budgeted. The question is, can we make that happen? I'm going to get a coffee.
Your husband is a tough negotiator.
No, that's not my husband. He's my Indiana members' credit union manager.
I better get my manager.
We are passionately committed to our members. We'll help you get into your new vehicle with 1.9% APR financing for auto, home, business, and more. Call or visit Indiana members' credit union today.
People always tell you what not to do. Don't hold your breath. Don't play with fire. Don't talk to strangers. Don't spend it all in one place. Find out what you can do. IUPUI, fulfilling the promise.
North Dakota State has sliced into this IUPUI lead. It's gone from 7-2. And a couple of free throws could tie this game up for the first time in quite some time.
North Dakota State has ramped up their defensive pressure. Number one, they created three turnovers. Secondly, they shot the ball well. They just seem much crisper, more directed in what they're doing offensively. And Warner in earlier, if you think about it. Gives them a big, strong body up front. Their four perimeter guys can all handle it, pass it, shoot it, go to the rim.
On the season, Dupree, a 65% shooter. Now 2-4 from the line tonight. As a team, North Dakota State, 8-11 from the stripe this evening. Jaguars remain 0-1. Foul this time whistled against Cabellas.
Well, post Matt O'Leary inside, quick pass. He can score inside. He's a great passer.
Josh James in there for the first time this half. Young man that spent last year away from the basketball team at IUPUI, was just a student at IUPUI. Good to see him back and writing a good final chapter to his days as a Jaguar. That ball was off the hands of Darrell Combs and touched Buddy Mayborg while he was out of bounds. So,
again,
another turnover.
Four turnovers, just over five minutes. And it was just an unnecessary turnover.
Miller for the lead. And his second three of the night.
I hate to be prophetic, but you just know he's going to get opportunities. And there's one when he has a clean look and it's in.
Miller the dish and James the finish.
There you go. I mean, go to the rim, create some things. Now you got to come back and start locking some people up defensively.
All eight players that have played tonight for IUPUI now to the scoring column.
Well, going zone again. Again, the risky run is not finding shooters when you zone. I like the change.
And Miller the give and go to Warner who missed it. And O'Leary out of there with it. A rare point-blank miss for Warner. Henderson off the hands of Dupree, out of bounds to IUPUI.
Greg, you can argue, okay, that wasn't a good possession defensively, and they had a point-blank shot at the rim. I would argue that you went zone and they didn't score, and another turnover.
Well, I thought that ball was off a North Dakota State player.
So did I.
Officials thought otherwise. Out of bounds to North Dakota State.
But again, you know, you went to zone. You're going to stay in it another possession. You tend to, if someone doesn't score on you, you tend to stay in it. If we're only two or three possessions, give them a different look and slow down this dribble penetration that's hurt you so much at the half court.
Ward back on the floor for North Dakota State. He had 11 in the first half. It's the third straight game that he has reached double digits off the bench. Shot clock at 7. Miller got the roll.
Guess who? You know, does a great job. We think of him as a three-point shooter. That's a strong move at the rim. In traffic, through contact, great cut and a great finish.
Aren't many guards in this league that are 6'6". He's one of them. Henderson.
Didn't stay. Good look, good penetration.
Great split by Miller. Ball was knocked away, though, by IUPUI. And a trio of starters to return for the Jaguars. Brennan, McCall, and Thomas all to return.
Well, whether you stay zone here, I mean, I think they go man. They seem like they're going to man up on this possession. Again, you just, if you only do it a couple of times, sometimes that gets you going in terms of your base defense.
IUPUI's most versatile defender in McCall draws assignment on Miller. Jacobson, the offensive rebound. Now Miller trying to post up McCall, had it stripped. And that is out of bounds off North Dakota State.
Great defense by DJ McCall. You know, I think Miller can get him on the perimeter, but DJ has the quickness, the size, obviously, to take him inside.
Well, not many guys in this league can match Miller's skill set in terms of athleticism.
Mm-hmm.
McCall is one of those guys.
Oh, absolutely. That's why I think he had such a subpar half in that first half. I say subpar. He had 9 in the first half and averages 15. But, you know, you didn't really notice him in that first half.
Nifty little jump hook by Aaron Brennan. He's got double figures now for a fourth consecutive game.
So you got to get inside so things can go from there, and Aaron Brennan needed that.
Jaguars back into the man-to-man. Ward, unable to dial up the same rhythm he had in half number one. Thomas off to the races. Thomas just forced something that wasn't there.
Well, a tough play. You had no numbers. You were 3-on-3, and you're going to try to split 2.
All alone is Jacobson.
Man, your transition defense, no one really communicating. Jacobson can knock that shot down all night.
He is a 48% three-point shooter. That is his first made three, his second try from distance this evening.
I think 48% is able to knock him down all night.
And that's going to be a foul on Miller, playing over the back of Aaron Brennan.
It's huge, though. One free throw attempt to this point by IUPUI. I mean, think about it. There haven't been a lot of fouls called in this. And certainly, you know, North Dakota State has been to the line 9 times and hit 7, but only one trip. And you are 12:05 on the clock.
Miller and Jacobson both getting a breather here for North Dakota State. Both teams with some key scores getting a breather on the bench. Combs and O'Leary currently getting a seat for IUPUI. Patterson, no. Cabellis rips away the rebound.
Pretty good look that didn't go.
Looking for Dengu. That pass was tipped away by McCall. It'll be out of bounds for North Dakota State. The Bison looking to run their record to 8-1 in Summit League play. They're in front by 3 on ESPN3.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Pizza Hut makes the best pizza under the moon. You see, when you're raised by wolves, there's no 10 any deal where you can carry out a large Pizza Hut pizza, any toppings, any recipe, any day of the week. No, you just starve while your wolf brothers sandbag all the fresh meat. But now, I can even carry out a large pan meat lovers for just 10 bucks, while Barky and Sparky look for their dinner in the woods like a bunch of animals. Look who's laughing now, wolves. The 10 any deal, because no one out pizzas the Hut.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
As expected, Paul Miller has been a major factor for the Bison in half number two. He's got seven in a variety of ways. North Dakota State leads by three.
Well, it's just obviously not Paul Miller, but their leading scorer creates things. You saw A.J. Jacobson, no one communicating. Miller obviously is the key. You saw the three. You saw the score inside going to the rim. It's a great, if you're North Dakota State, you kind of like the fact that your guy's starting to take over in the second half. Certainly reflects in a three-point lead for the Bison.
O'Leary returned at the dead ball for IUPUI. Miller and Jacobson continue to have a quick spell on the pine for NDSU. Ward, first points of the second half.
It's a great move, and the heavens open up, and I think Matt O'Leary may have gotten hit in the head and the nose. Trying to defend Dexter Werner.
Largest lead of the game now for North Dakota State.
Well, you're down Evan Hall with a concussion, going through the concussion protocol. Understandably, Jason Gardner a little concerned. Maybe we can see it here. You go up, and I just think that, yep, came right down. It wasn't in the defense of Werner. It was trying to slide over and defend Tyson Ward, and Ward's arm just caught him right in the nose.
So plus 12 here in the second half for North Dakota State. Thomas lost the handle. Been a rough night for Kellen.
It's been a rough night for the rough second half for the Jags offensively, Greg. Again, you know, turnovers up to 10. You had five in the first half. You have five in the first half of the second half.
This has been North Dakota State's MO this year. Tough shot by Werner.
It's a tough shot. He's so strong. And again, if you don't bring the extra body, and it's hard to bring the extra body when you know that they can shoot the threes as well as they do.
Werner now the third Bison player in double figures tonight. Combs will check in next dead ball. Good seal by Brennan. Good lead pass by McCall.
Well, and good ball movement. You kept moving the basketball, didn't get stagnant with the ball, didn't try to go one-on-one and create some stuff. Back to the zone.
Ward doesn't get the roll. And this is a little bit of an easier team to zone when Paul Miller's on the bench.
That's a great point. That's why they did it. It's a great point.
Thomas gets the friendly bounce.
Got away with one, dodged a bullet on the pass. Cuts it to three, gets yourself a possession. Get a good defensive stop here.
Ball tipped away, but right to Carlin Dupree. Three yet to score tonight. Werner shot blocked. But the putback is there by Ward.
Man, you did everything. It's that whole everything but syndrome, Greg. You did everything except keep the ball from going in. A great defensive possession for about 28, 29 seconds.
Miller will check back in next dead ball for North Dakota State.
Oh.
Thomas, not that time. McCall able to keep it alive.
Great hustle.
Brennan.
We can't fault the hustle on the part of DJ McCall, and Aaron Brennan had a good look.
Well, the difference maker Ward has been for North Dakota State tonight. Dengu, no. Out of bounds off of Aaron Brennan.
And the big key, too, is look at the amount of rest that Paul Miller's been able to get. They bring him back now, but you know, you didn't lose anything when he left the court.
Henderson back in for IUPUI along with Darrell Combs and Josh James.
Bench has been important for both teams. I mean, I know statistically North Dakota State has the advantage, but I will tell you what, both teams have gotten great minutes out of their bench.
Both teams have played eight-man rotations tonight.
Yeah, and this is just too easy a foul. You know, Matt O'Leary called holding. It's too easy. I mean, A.J. Jacobson makes just a little simple cut, and Matt kind of caught off guard, grabs him.
Just the fifth team foul against IUPUI. Dupree. Good defense by McCall.
Absolutely. He fought through, you know, he got caught behind the screen, but was able to pick him back up and do a great job of bodying up.
Combs, no. McCall ties up Miller. The arrow does go the other way. But you're starting to see the activity of DJ McCall pick up.
Absolutely. I think you're also starting to see, hopefully that energy is passed on to his teammates because they're somewhat lethargic, especially on the offensive end.
By the way, that shot for Combs. He's sitting on just 8 points tonight. Jacobson, no. O'Leary.
Got the shot you wanted, just didn't go.
McCall got lucky. That ball hit Miller last. And that will give IUPUI a chance to set some things up in this timeout. They trail by five. It's a much-needed victory, a possibility at it for IUPUI here at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum.
Oh, yes. There you go. A little dribble drive.
Feel the intensity of NCAA March Madness.
The shot drops.
You've got to see it to believe it. The 2017 NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Championship first and second rounds. March 17th and 19th at the Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Visit ncaa.com/MBB tickets for your seats today.
Great Dating City Barbecue.
People always tell you what not to do. Don't get your clothes dirty. Don't bite off more than you can chew. Don't cross the line. Don't make faces. Find out what you can do. IUPUI, fulfilling the promise.
Numbers across the board, very even in this game, as you'd expect in a 5-point basketball game. The biggest difference right now, well, two in favor of North Dakota State. One bench point. They lead that 26-9. But free throws, they've made eight. The Jaguars remain 0-for-1. North Dakota State has committed just seven fouls in 32 minutes.
Well, think about it. Seven fouls and six turnovers, as opposed to IUPUI, 11 fouls, 10 turnovers, five of those turnovers in the second half.
O'Leary trying to draw a foul, didn't get it, but his aggressiveness leads to the tip-in basket by Josh James.
Big job, big rebound, and a good hoop for Josh James. Needed hoop, much needed hoop.
Josh averaging 2 points a game, has four tonight. And back to a one possession game. Back to a man-to-man for IUPUI. Dupree on the drive. James there waiting on him.
How about it? You get a little energy. You get the basket, you come down, you get energized, you make a great defensive play.
Jaguars just 1-3 in five tries in this half. O'Leary.
Well, it's a tough angle. Tough angle for DJ McCall. Bounce it once, dribble it, get a better angle. Got to go.
Henderson.
Boom. There you go, right there. See? Sometimes you just keep moving, good things happen for you.
Second three of this half for IUPUI. They're at their average for a home game. They've got 10. And we're tied up with 6:40 to play. Werner and Ward about to check back in for the Bison. Little show and go from Jacobson that O'Leary never bid on. Jacobson.
Got now, the separation.
In a case of where the ball doesn't lie, the shot didn't go.
Absolutely.
Combs, good block by Dengu. Ruled to be out of bounds off of IUPUI. And the Jaguars certainly thought that ball was touched last by a North Dakota State player.
See, and I thought DJ McCall was the guy to get the last touch. You know, just a tough. Would have been a good momentum in your favor right now, and you could have benefited from that. So now you got to come back and get another good defensive possession if you're IUPUI.
Great little two-man game between Warner and Miller. They've done this quite well the last couple of years. And Jacobson, no missing that one. Arm, forearm into the chest of Darrell Combs, and Jacobson gets whistled for the foul.
Much better defense the last two or three times down the floor for IUPUI, Greg. And yeah, I mean, Jacobson just kind of extended it. You'll get a better angle here. This is a pretty easy one to call. And, you know, good sales job, too. Well, let's be honest, but there was contact.
Jags led the entirety of the first half, well, virtually 18 and a half minutes of it. It's been primarily North Dakota State in this half. Shot clock in single digits.
Yeah, you've been deep in shot clock the last two times, and you settled for threes. You got one to go. Josh James working hard on the glass. Just couldn't get it.
Out of bounds to North Dakota State. North Dakota State has not made a field goal in the last 4 minutes.
Problem is IUPUI has not been able to take advantage of some of those opportunities.
They've only made a couple during that time themselves. James almost got the steal. Cabelas and O'Leary with the rebound. Yet another chance for IUPUI to go in front. And good timeout by Jason Gardner. Neither coach had used a timeout in the second half. Jason Gardner says, all right, we kind of value this possession. It'll be a timeout. We'll step aside too. 4:56 left to play. We're all tied up at 60.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at drivehubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click drivehubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Tied at 60 here at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum. Quick look at the shooting stats for these two teams tonight. Again, that's been in favor of IUPUI from an overall standpoint.
Right.
Very little separating these two teams as we speak.
But, you know, you're 2 of 7. You're IUPUI, obviously, 29%. And you in the last four or five possessions, it's deep in possession. You know, when you're in that shot clock under 5 seconds, you tend to obviously settle for some shots you probably don't want to take, and they've been victimized by that. Different look offensively, which is good coming out of a timeout. You're going to get you into your normal offense, but
Patterson
again. It gives you opportunities to spot some shooters like Ron Patterson for a big three. Great timeout. Great call by Coach Garden.
It's 8 in a row for IUPUI. It's 8 in total for Patterson. And it's 11 threes and 20 tries for the Jaguars tonight. Warner, tough shot.
Tough shot, but, you know, they clear aside and just let him play. IUPUI, Ron Patterson kind of bluffed his way. He's a tough matchup one-on-one.
Warner off the bench, averages 11. He's got 13 tonight. Henderson in for Thomas. Patterson in for McCall. Henderson, 7 for the sophomore.
A great use of the screen, great hesitation move. We love him when he goes to the rim.
The sophomore from Cecina averages 5.5 points a game. Ward, able to find Cabelas. Got to go up. Ward on cue. Everything else has fallen. Didn't get the roll, and Henderson gave the foul to prevent the easy bucket for Warner.
Everything but, again, Greg, a couple of those times, I thought that was in. It didn't go.
Warner will have 2 free throws, and we come back. Less than 3.5 to play.
Pizza Hut makes the best pizza under the moon. You see, when you're raised by wolves, there's no 10-any deal where you can carry out a large Pizza Hut pizza, any toppings, any recipe, any day of the week. No, you just starve while your wolf brothers sandbag all the fresh meat. But now, I can even carry out a large pan meat lovers for just 10 bucks, while Barky and Sparky look for their dinner in the woods like a bunch of animals. Look who's laughing now, wolves. The 10-any deal, because no one out-pizzas the Hut.
Yes, there you go. A little dribble drive.
Feel the intensity of NCAA March Madness.
The shot drops.
You've got to see it to believe it. The 2017 NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Championship first and second rounds. March 17th and 19th at the Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Visit ncaa.com/MBB tickets for your seats today.
It's pretty simple. That's the car she wants, and this is the price she has budgeted. The question is, can we make that happen? I'm gonna get a coffee.
Your husband is a tough negotiator.
No, that's not my husband. He's my Indiana Members Credit Union manager.
I better get my manager.
We are passionately committed to our members. We'll help you get into your new vehicle with 1.9% APR financing for auto, home, business, and more. Call or visit Indiana Members Credit Union today.
Again, the bench battle has largely gone to North Dakota State tonight, but as of late, two guys that certainly are pulling like starters are Patterson and Henderson, a pair of Indianapolis kids for Jason Gardner.
Yeah, in different ways. Ron Patterson with the three out of a timeout and a design play. And T.J. Henderson, as he does so well, he's quick to the rim and can finish. You like the balance, the inside out. Now your challenge is to come out and sustain some things. You're in this situation that they've been in quite frequently now, Greg, especially on the road, where inside 3 minutes, you got to make plays. I mean, it's just that simple. You know, there's no magic to it. I'm not exactly sure what the formula is. You just have to be tough enough to take care of the ball and make plays.
You got to win one to get some confidence. That's what IUPUI needs right now. And, of course, everybody else in the Summit League cheering for IUPUI.
Oh, absolutely.
Trying to bring the Bison back to the pack. As I mentioned earlier, they are 2 games clear in the loss column of everybody else in the league at 7-1.
And that's big. And Werner, I love him. You know, he's strong. You know he's going to go to the free throw line. 74% free throw shooter. That's strong stuff.
And he is 5 of 6 tonight.
Well, another design play, a little different look to your offense.
Henderson again. Right at Werner and scores.
You play to his strength. It's a great call again. You come out of a timeout, you run the crossing guards, and Henderson stops, kind of backs up off the screen and gets an angle to the rim.
Both teams getting some unlikely points off the bench tonight. Ward for North Dakota State. Henderson for IUPUI. Speaking of Ward, there he is again. 17 for Tyson Ward.
He's literally has had a fantastic game. No one gets a chance to get a body on him because of the rotations, and that is a big follow-up.
That is a new career high for Ward. Previously, it was 15.
Ron Patterson just calling for the ball in that corner. Didn't get it.
Got to go up. Patterson obliges. Oh! Patterson cashes in.
No wonder he was asking for it so much.
Double digits in 7 straight games for Patterson. Cabela's comes right back.
Don't close him out. You sprint back. You got to get a hand in his face, and Cabela's can knock down the shot.
There's a reason why they're the top team in the league.
Absolutely.
Bison ranked 82nd in the RPI coming into today's game.
Well, we talked about their composure as a veteran group and what a great second-half basketball team they are. They expect to win. It does, obviously, what they've done in the second half has been remarkable.
The slip for Brennan. Not that time. Patterson kept it alive, but Ward finds it. Down to 90 seconds left to play. Both these teams have been outstanding from three-point range. A foul's going to be called on Brennan, and it's 1 plus the bonus on the 7th IUPUI foul.
Yeah, on the other side, North Dakota State's only fouled 4 times. That's big. Yeah, here you are, just under a minute and a half. You haven't been to the free throw line at all. You've been to the free throw line 1 time in IUPUI. And Werner is really solid at the line.
Ties us up at 70. And this game came down to a buzzer beater from IUPUI a season ago. Hit a shot with a second left to play in the game.
We talked about the 3-game losing streak, and here you are. Same situations, right? Opportunities. And as simple as it sounds, team that wins is the team that makes these plays, takes advantage of these opportunities.
Patterson, not that time. Brennan, able to at least keep it alive. No need to be in a hurry here if you're IUPUI. You got a full shot clock to work with.
Yeah, absolutely. And yet, you know, Ron Patterson, I'm fine. You let him take that shot all night long.
Patterson with 11 points. He's had double digits in 7 consecutive games. IUPUI with 12 made threes tonight. Again, they've been averaging 10 per game at home here in the Indiana Farmers Coliseum. Combs, O'Leary, and Patterson all online to make over 50 threes this season, which has never happened in school history. Frankly, there's enough games left in the season. They might all clear 60 threes for the season. Patterson with 3 off the bench tonight. O'Leary with 5 made threes this evening. All in all, 5 different IUPUI players have connected from distance tonight.
Well, you got 1:04 on the clock, 21 on the shot clock. So you're going to have another opportunity or two. Your IUPUI, you know, like the play that they came out and went to Ron Patterson in the corner. You know, they 1-4. You cross the wings, spot them up in the corner. Try to get a ball screen for your point guard to penetrate. You also know that this is the time of a ball game where Darrell Combs is going to have the ball in his hands and try to create some things. So you look for those kinds of things. At the other end, I'd be surprised if they don't try to find Werner inside as much as they possibly can. North Dakota State's had great luck with that, and I'd keep going to him as much as I can.
Last year, IUPUI won the game here against the Bison. 73-72 on a 3 with 2 seconds left to play.
Remember the game, remember it well. And here's the thing, you're in a similar situation. You've got opportunity, you don't have to go quickly in the shot clock.
By the way, of note, that was a year and a day ago, January the 31st of 2016.
So, you know, now you with Henderson at the point, you're trying to create some things he can create, Darrell Combs can create.
Combs bumped.
One, oh, my goodness.
They're going to wave off the shot. And again, because of the scarcity of fouls against North Dakota State in this game.
Well, you see it here. That's tough. That is tough. But to be, you know, to be fair, buddy, Mayborg's waving it off the entire way.
So a full 30. There's still a foul to give.
Exactly.
If you're North Dakota State.
You know, and the key here is, again, you have time on the clock. I think you take the best shot you have, irrespective of where you are time-wise. I've always believed that. And then you put the pressure on your defense and see if they can respond.
24-second difference, shot clock and game clock.
Well, this is pretty obvious what happens now. Darrell Combs is going to try to create something.
Pull up two. Got it.
Kind of like that, I think is what he was trying to create.
He becomes the fourth different Jaguar in double digits. Game clock and shot clock are virtually identical. Ward all the way in.
A complete breakdown defensively. No one communicates. No one steps off the screen. No one communicates. And as he's done all night, Tyson Ward is big.
The only good news out of allowing a wide open dunk if you're IUPUI, it happened so quickly.
Right.
You've got 22 seconds at the other end to try to get a shot.
Well, and you'll see it here. You see the end of it. But what you don't see is, you know, no one communicates a little ball screen. No one steps out. And literally, it's as if Tyson Ward is not seen by anyone going to the rim for the big finish. I mean, the heavens, excuse me, the sea parts, and he has a clean path to the rim. And it's those types of situations, Greg, again, making those plays. And that's inexcusable at this time of the game.
Let us again point out, North Dakota State has a foul to give.
Absolutely.
So they can be a little more aggressive on, say, a drive to the basket, knowing the shot clock is already turned off.
Well, I don't think there's going to be any magic in this play. It's going to be run the clock down and let Darrell Combs try to go one-on-one and create some things. If he has an opening, he'll take it. You have Ron Patterson, who spotted up. And I think Coach Richmond calls time season alignment. Wants to make sure that everyone understands who's in, who's doing what, and steadies himself and steadies his players to know what's happening.
So back-to-back timeouts taken by North Dakota State. If we get to a held ball scenario, the arrow does point towards IUPUI. Looking for three-point shooters.
Well,
clearly there have been plenty of those for IUPUI tonight. And in fact, the five players on the floor for IUPUI, I think, have all made a three tonight.
Well, you have a great offensive unit out there. Henderson can go to the rim and finish. We know what Darrell Combs can do. Ron Patterson can spot and hit three. Your two bigs can knock down threes and go to the rim. So you have guys who can all create off the dribble and go to the rim. They all can knock down threes.
Combs hit the game winner against South Dakota State in their last win 2 weeks ago. It was from the high right side, about 19 feet away. Let's see if he's going to try this yet again. Off the screen. Combs lost the handle. Loose ball. Timeout given to North Dakota State. So they will have a look with 1.2 seconds remaining. It is the final timeout.
Well, it's clear that they're just going to try to make sure there's 1.2. And at this particular point, you know, you're going to have time maybe for a catch and a bounce, but probably not. So assuming it's 1.2, I think North Dakota State's strategy clearly might be try to create an opportunity for Werner inside or for Paul Miller on a catch-and-shoot opportunity. So we're trying to figure it out right now. Our crew is trying to figure out if we can get the specifics. So both teams have to stay in their huddles. So we're going to be able to see this. Since it's not definitive, Greg, they're going to go with 1.2.
I think at most it would have been, and we can surmise the graphic, and we can tell you that the graphic is synced up to the game clock, but the officials can't go with it. They have to go with line of sight.
Right.
At most, a tenth or two would have been added.
And without a definitive look, they can't overturn it. Now, as I mentioned, I mean, I think you look, you've got Miller coming off screens. It's, you know, you're trying to set whatever multiple screens if you can. You always have Werner to try to, you have him inside as your last chance.
It's Cabela's who caught it out of bounds.
He got.
Now time ran off the clock.
They're going to have the same situation. Just got to check this again. We're going to have to take another look because, time ran off the clock. Tough play. I think the North Dakota State fans are wondering. They thought he might have been forced out. Well, I think we're going to have overtime here, Greg, in just a second. I think it's going to be a difficult thing to have. And you know what? It's been it's been that much fun. Going to leave it as it is?
No, they're going to add some time to it.
Time.
They're going to add some time.
All right, so obviously you're looking in – you're there in tip. It's going to have to be a tip or a catch. And based upon what we put back on, you'll have enough time for a catch and a shoot.
Basically, the ruling was enough time for him to literally touch the ball. Point three comes off, basically.
Okay.
And IUPUI does have a timeout here, and they're going to call it right now to design something. So, point three, the rule is you got to tip it. Above that, you can catch and shoot. At point nine, you can catch and shoot.
Now's catch and shoot. And the question is to whom you're going to go. And I think you have guys who are certainly capable of it. But it's been a fun game, I'm telling you right now. Nice run by the Jags to get back to this point. Again, victimized by that opportunities that they're not able to take advantage of. But, you know, the big key if you're North Dakota State, you do not want to foul. Same thing with IUPUI. Please, screeners, stop. Do not move and get an illegal screen call on you at this particular point in the ball game.
Allow me to bring this up again. I think you can do it with 0.9 seconds left. The Bison do have a foul to give on a non-shooting scenario.
Yeah, there's That's tough. Jake. Watch multiple screens. I think you're going to screen in for Patterson. You're going to get multiple screens as much as you can. There he is right there.
Patterson in time, but short.
Pretty good play.
Got a great look, just didn't get enough to it.
Pretty good play.
Let us quickly step aside. We got 5 more minutes of basketball left to go from the Indiana Farmers Coliseum as we're all tied up at 72.
Life's too short to drive a car you hate. Get a car you love at driveHubler.com because Hubler is the dealer that helps the people. For over 50 years, the Hubler family has helped Hoosier families get approved. We have over 40 eager lenders ready to approve you. Then shop certified used vehicles starting at $49.95, all with a 2-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty. Let Hubler help you now. Click driveHubler.com or call 1-888-377-5588.
Come in, click, or call. Hubler has it all.
Yes, there you go. A little dribble drive.
Feel the intensity of NCAA March Madness.
The shot drops.
You've got to see it. to believe it. The 2017 NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Championship first and second rounds. March 17th and 19th at the Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Visit ncaa.com/MBB tickets for your seats today.
To overtime we go for the second time in the last 15 days here at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum. The last overtime game was the last IUPUI win, 85-83 against South Dakota State on January the 18th.
Well, I mean, your strategies here are obviously pretty clear. You just got to continue to play the way you're playing. IUPUI has to get back and get a little more crisp and sharp in their offense. They've been a little stagnant. Obviously, when you're in late-game situations, things change a little bit. But now the problem is you haven't been to the free-throw line. Greg, think about this amazing stat. After 40 minutes, IUPUI has taken one free-throw attempt and missed it. And on the other end, South Dakota State, 8 for 11. And think about it. Excuse me, 11 for 15. And that's a startling thing because you've been trying to go to the rim and give North Dakota State credit. They haven't fouled. They really haven't.
Here's the remarkable thing. Normally when you go to overtime, you're worried about being a war of attrition. Nobody's got more than three fouls.
No, not at all.
Now, IUPUI isn't even the bonus at this point.
It's been a cleanly played game, well-officiated game. It's almost like football. I mean, you really want to get on the board first. You really do.
Brennan will try the left-hand runner and wouldn't go. Brennan has 13 tonight, one of four Jaguars in double figures. Leading scorer is Ward, the freshman for North Dakota State, with a career-high 19. Jacobson, the backdoor cut. Patterson got a hand on it. O'Leary got another hand on it, and eventually ripped out of there by IUPUI.
Great defense, great hands inside.
Speaking of good hands, that one knocked away from Combs. O'Leary, one more time. That's 6 out of 8 for Matt O'Leary.
Just the way he started the ballgame. He's just been phenomenal from three tonight.
22 for O'Leary. Miller, that's a 2, and it barely grazes the iron. But Warner is everywhere for North Dakota State.
It really is. It was short. You know, there was no rebound. O'Leary lost sight of it, and Warner able to get the ball. Give him a chance again for another shot.
The 22 points for O'Leary, the most in a league game for him this year. His first game of more than 20 since non-conference play. Warner left that short. Brennan might have got away with getting him on the arm
on
that one.
What Aaron Brennan did was just muscle up with him, just chested him, you know, did not create the foul. Just good defense inside.
The 6 threes made by O'Leary, by the way, ties Darrell Combs for most threes made in a game this season for IUPUI. Steal by Ward. Patterson hustles back and got him on the head and the and-one opportunity.
You have two mistakes on the same play. You turn it over, you foul a shooter. And certainly, the expression on Coach Gardner's face says it all. You got the big three. Take care of the basketball. Don't compound your problem after you've thrown it away by fouling a driving shooting player.
First free throw for Ward tonight, a 65% shooter, but 22 for Ward.
He's been superb. He really has.
Between Werner and Ward, 38 of the 75 for North Dakota State have come from off the bench.
How about it?
Patterson. The slip for Brennan. Not that time, but kept alive. Brennan cannot finish. O'Leary, great hands. And then Henderson throws it away.
Just look at Ward. I mean, two straight steals. Think about it. The rookie for the steals. And it was just a disjointed possession anyway, but they hustled, thought they had an opportunity.
Oh, Ward. And when it's not him, it's Warner, although he missed it. And Henderson, I think that's off the leg of a North Dakota State player. It is.
Man, How hard are these guys playing, Greg? I mean, look at the effort on the part of both teams.
I don't think North Dakota State views this game as they have a cushion right now atop
still,
the Summit League standings.
They're playing. Both teams playing. You see it right here. If you can see it, we kind of got blocked out by Chris Beaver. That's great hustle.
And they play to a four-point game. January the 5th in Fargo.
Yep.
It was a one-point game here a year ago. It has all the earmarks of a last possession game here
absolutely.
In overtime.
And both coaches looking at it the same way. We had opportunities. We've had looks. We've had opportunities. Jags have not taken good care of the basketball in overtime.
Each team with 3 points in the extra session. Brennan looking for three more.
How about the bigs knocking down the threes here in the overtime?
16 for Aaron Brennan. That is his second three of the night. The offense has been run through Warner late in the game for North Dakota State and just bulls his way through Brennan and scores yet again.
That's the reason why. You know, you're not going to get the extra body. You're not going to double him in the post. Throw it to him. He'll take a couple bounces. He's a great free throw shooter.
But it is a one-point lead for IUPUI. By the way, Brennan now 16 points, a brand new career high.
Oh,
that's a flop. And O'Leary got it to go.
Got nice try because he had the mismatch inside, and Matt O'Leary is able to finish it.
Back to a three-point game. Both teams have a full timeout, an extra timeout for overtime. Stripped by Combs. Henderson, two on one. Henderson, O'Leary, no, does not go. That was half the way down.
Oh, my. Oh, my. Well, you got to defend now.
And there's going to be a foul called on Henderson. It'll be one plus the bonus for Paul Miller. And, my goodness, that had all the intentions of being a two-possession game.
Man, oh, man. Again, not to belabor the point. Got to finish. You know, it's easy to sit here in this position and say finish, but those are things that you have to do, and that's the difference between wins and losses, Greg, those types of plays.
Miller 2 for 2 from the line tonight. This is one plus the bonus, but he connects. And IUPUI leading this game with 33.7 seconds left to go in overtime, and they have not made a free throw tonight. Both teams going to start going a little offense-defense here as Miller makes the free throw. McCall had entered, replacing Patterson. Now Patterson back in. Dupree in for Warner as North Dakota State will go small, and they'll pick up full-court pressure.
I like this. If you haven't seen it tonight, so you're going to move, you get your quicks up front, put pressure.
And again,
maybe you can get a turnover.
North Dakota State has a foul to give. So they can be aggressive here. But at the same time, if you give that foul, well, now it's no longer a discussion. But now the shot clock is turned
off.
Which means that
you're
again gonna go for a foul at North Dakota State. And I think the Bison are gonna call their final timeout, I believe. Nope, not yet. In fact,
I think he's gonna
I can hear David Richmond saying right away they're gonna foul when the ball is inbounded.
So now this will be they're at six. You have to. When you're down, you gotta create. One thing they're trying to do, though, is they're trying to get the steal on the inbound.
Brennan is fouled. And Brennan from the free throw line, 76% on the season. And this is literally just the second attempt of the night for IUPUI from the line.
Well, it's a staggering stat. I mean, it really is. You and I have done this for a while. You do not see – I think everyone understands you don't see it very often. I think everyone understands the situation, too. Makes two. You're still a one-possession game. So I think we're ready for a second overtime, just in case.
Brennan with 17.
See, big. I mean, you got to make free throws. I mean, normally, obviously, you know, your late-game MO is you got to take care of it. You got to make free throws. You got to get stops.
This is the big one here. And the young man connects.
How about it?
Do you give a foul here if you're IUPUI?
Well, not right now. You got to get deeper in the shot clock. It won't matter right here.
Miller blocked by Patterson. That's goaltending. Got it off the backboard. So Miller's first field goal in some time. He's now got 20.
Same scenario, Greg. You're going to full court pressure. You're going for the steal. You're in denial. You're trying to deny the inbound. You're trying to foul as soon as it comes in. If you can get a steal, if you can get a deflection, you'll see. The big thing about it is, you know, if you're IUPUI, don't foul when you're trying to set a screen. Make sure you're set.
Jaguars do have a timeout in case they need it. Cabela's checks out for North Dakota State because he's got four fouls.
And don't push off.
And that's a foul on Carlin Dupree. And now T.J. Henderson goes to the line where, like Brennan, he is a 76% shooter on the year.
We can hear David Richmond saying the same thing. Yeah, it's exactly.
In other words, get to the basket, extend the game.
Get to the basket, extend the game. Yeah, that's exactly what you do. Space the court, get to the rim. And now, you know, it's pretty simple. The Jags got to make free throws.
Henderson does just that. Henderson now with 10. One of five IUPUI players in double figures. Again, this is the crucial one here. Buries it. Both teams have one timeout remaining. IUPUI will go small.
Yep.
They'll bring Kellen Thomas in.
So DJ McCall will be matched up, or they're going to put Ron Patterson on Werner.
Because they want McCall on Miller.
Absolutely.
And it'll be Henderson instead. Miller on the bounce. Deep three, Miller. Missed that one. Long rebound. Thomas blocked out Ward just to make sure he couldn't get to it.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, now you got to look. You got to get the basketball in. You're in a tough spot on the – think about this, Greg. You have to get the ball inbounds. Your inbound spot is in the dead corner, almost dead corner. So you have to get it inbounds. You can't turn it over. You don't want to get the 5 second. The key here is you got to inbound the basketball.
And Dengu has been entered just to face guard Matt O'Leary. And Jaguars do have a timeout if needed. Patterson. And Werner wraps him up. And Patterson, who isn't a great free throw shooter, 64%, one plus the bonus. Now I will bring up the scenario about potentially giving a foul if you're IUPUI with 4.6, if he doesn't make the first free throw.
Again, it's a philosophical discussion. Some coaches, yes, some don't. I mean, you look at it statistically. Teams shoot, what, 30s, in the 30s and from three? So, but I think Coach Gardner's philosophy is to give the foul, and you do it with this particular amount of time.
It's a moot point. By the way, Jason was telling T.J. Henderson, if he misses, foul him.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, wipe that off.
Again, I think the prevailing thought nowadays is that you foul, but there are still people who believe that, you know, let's defend. The percentages are in our favor if we defend.
Didn't make a free throw in regulation, went 6 of 6 from the free throw line in overtime, and IUPUI snaps a three-game losing streak by beating the still first-place team in the Summit League, the Bison of North Dakota State.
This was a game where you needed confidence. Your confidence has been shaken in these last three games that you've lost, and you hope that you get that confidence out. You get some time off. You get the weekend off. It's a great win. The manner in which they did it, Greg, you know, came down, had some chances that didn't go, came out in that overtime period and really were the aggressor.
Career high 6 threes for Matt O'Leary, 24 points in total. Career high period for Aaron Brennan. He finishes with 18. A much needed win for IUPUI. Only bad news for the Jags after this one, they don't play for 7 days. They're on the road in Omaha next Wednesday night. Our next broadcast of IUPUI basketball will be on Saturday night, February the 11th. The Jaguars play host to Oral Roberts. For Bob Lovell, this is Greg Regstraw. For the second time in as many weeks, Jaguars win at home in overtime. We thank you for watching on ESPN3.
great Dady City barbecue.
People always tell you what not to do. Don't hold your breath. Don't play with fire. Don't talk to strangers. Don't spend it all in one place. Find out what you can do. IUPUI, fulfilling the promise.